What's up, guys? Working for another night on the dump trailer, just trying to tidy up some odds and ends here. As you can see, we got the dump bed in the air. I'm gonna work on some kind of stabilizer bar to hold it up. Charlie says hi. And we're gonna weld some stuff up. And I'll show you that here in a second. So that's one of the projects I'll be working on. We still need to weld up these cross members. I need to cut these fender skirts out. I'm gonna try and set this camera up and get to work. All right, Charlie is excited to get started on this, and so am I. So when your hoist is up, the only thing holding this heavy-ass bed in the air is your hydraulic system, which is, you guys have seen me work on it. It's that hose, that pump, and that cylinder, and it's got electric solenoids. So if anything goes wrong with that, you blow a hose, a seal suddenly fails, or the solenoids short out, this entire bed would drop on you if you were working under here. That's why all commercially built dump beds, I think it's an OSHA requirement, but all commercially built dump beds have a safety bar. And I've been using this, which is a piece of like 2-inch schedule 40 pipe. The thing with it is, you know, it can pop out or it can slide. So what we're gonna do today is I'm gonna cut these little threaded portions off just to give it a cleaner appearance. I am going to weld. I chopped off a little piece of tube. So once I cut those off, whoops. All right, if I can hold on to it long enough to show you, once I cut the threaded portions off, I'm gonna grind this down to fit, and I'm gonna weld it down inside of this so that we can run a bolt through this as a hinge and not have to worry about it crushing the tubing, which would compromise its structural integrity. And the other thing we're gonna do is cut a little piece of pipe. I'm gonna find a nice spot up on the dump bed, wherever, and weld that. And that way, when you hinge this up and put it in there, it can't jiggle and fall out. All right, that took me a little bit longer than I thought it would, just mostly because things are scattered inside and outside, but basically this is what I'm working on. We welded a couple pieces of steel with holes drilled in them, and I welded that piece of pipe I cut and ground to fit in there. You can see right here, we put that cup up here. So you run your hoist up. Since I was using this bar right here to block it, you'll see it come off of that. There we go. I was just using that while I worked under it. There we go. All right, I was just using that piece of bar while I worked on this, but you can see your cup up there. So it's gonna be hard to do with one hand, but basically you hold your thing up here and you put it down. We'll put the camera back on the tripod and I'll show you how it works. All right, hopefully you'll be able to see how this works here. So if you needed to do maintenance on this or work under it, you would run your hoist up, you reach out and grab your bar, and then you lower your hoist. And your little piece of pipe up here just keeps it from sliding out or kicking out. So this is what it will look like when it's in like a safe position. Your little cup up here, just hold your pipe in place. It's very sturdy, and your hinge at the bottom keeps it from kicking out. Anyway, this is going to be probably part of a longer video where I do some other smaller things, and the installation of this will be pretty sped up because it's pretty simple. So I need to weld up these cross members, pound them into place, Not sure if I'm gonna get that tonight or not. I need to cut their skirts out. That's gonna be a dirty, messy job. But for now, this is another little tick box on the trailer project. What's up, guys? Me and Charlie here today, working on the dump trailer some more. The project at hand today is trying to beef up the crossmember or the hoist mounts. I'm gonna show you what we're doing. All right, so this hoist was mounted to these three pieces of box tubing that are welded together. That's how it was when I got this dump bed and hoist. And the guy said he had had that together welded to the frame on a truck, and he just cut the whole thing off. So I was thinking if the frame was level, that would keep the whole thing level. That's why I just left it all together. It's one of the few spots on the welding on the dump bed that actually seems like it was good as far as the weld and everything goes, so I just left it together. I was kind of thinking with the force of the hoist in the center and that box tube tripled up there, that it wouldn't be much of a risk of bending this cross member, because this is these are really heavy. It's like quarter inch web, almost quarter inch on that old camper trailer frame. So I didn't brace it at all, but I was showing it to a buddy of mine. He was like, hey, let me tell you, you are gonna have problems. You're gonna bend that, because this, when it puts your bed up, if you lift a heavy load, it's pushing this way to push the bed up. So anytime you push, you're pushing backwards. So it's gonna be pushing backwards right against this crossmember. He said, you're gonna bow this crossmember up. So I salvaged a couple more sections of frame off of that right down here. I cut these. And today I'm gonna notch those. And I'm going to have to cut out this angle cross member, and I'm going to weld these sections in like this to brace that dump cross member off of these front cross members. All right, I thought this was recording while I did this work, but apparently not. So I've got these pieces of frame that I trimmed, and trimmed them 40 inches to fit between this cross member and the front cross member. I cut out the existing angle iron cross member. And then, as you can see, these are, they actually end up fitting snug in that, I guess there's no light there. These fit snug in that front cross member. This is more heavy channel right here, this angle piece. So as you can see, it's gonna meet this right up by this. And I may even come back and plate over this to give that bracing some extra strength. But I have a feeling this is, I mean, it's not super thick, but welded that close in against that, that's probably gonna be pretty strong the way it is. We'll see if I end up plating that or not. But I'm gonna have to tap these down just enough so I can grind out some of these goobers and stuff, I guess, from old welds. I may go ahead and just cut out that, whatever this little piece is, but I just need to polish up this and tap this up flush with that. And then not only am I welding this to brace this crossmember, it'll actually be welding this. So if this tries to, this is mounted at the top of this piece, so if it tries to flex this whole piece down, it's gonna have the crossmember resisting, and it'll have this braced, which if you kind of imagine, it's a diagonal. So it forms a triangle to brace back against these. That'll be super strong. So all I gotta do now is tap these down and get to grinding. Hopefully this thing will record this time. All right, it's a bright new day. Let's go ahead and get some more work done.
I'll find another production.
Feel like I got them burned in pretty good. So the next project here, I guess, is cutting off these bent up fender skirts because they're rubbing on the tires as we go up and down with the hoist. And you know, I may clamp them in here and weld them up just to give it a little more strength, but it doesn't look like it needs it. It's just fenders. So basically what's going on, these fenders, like I said, I got these like basically free off marketplace. You can see where we've had them before, had like pried them off of whatever they were on. I think he said it was a horse trailer or something. So he had like stuck a pry bar or something down there and bent them up. And there's, you know, it'll be a lot of work to try and straighten that. And they hung down underneath the dump bed on this trailer. So there were... Like if it was the top part, it'd be easy to weld them in and then pound it out as you go. And then the weld itself would hold it flat. But there's nothing down there. I would have had to like weld metal in behind them really to get that to straighten out. It just didn't seem worth the effort for the intended use of this trailer. So I just decided to cut all this out. It's cutting out extra weight and it makes sure that's never gonna rub against these tires or anything like that. So I guess we'll drop it down and see how it looks. All right, here you can see these fenders with that skirt cut out. I think it looks just fine. What's up guys, back to work on the dump trailer. I'm gonna try and weld these fenders up in here, grind them down, do that real quick just to get the little thing done. I don't have a whole lot of time to work on it right now. Just a shot of showing what I did. This is kind of thin. You can see I shot a couple holes through it. It's what you get messing with old metal. But the rest of it turned out, so it turned out pretty good. Oh, it's got this side finished up. Looks pretty good. It's really tightened up. It's tightened up. The whole feeling of the bed doesn't rattle anymore. Doesn't shake around as much. So I'm gonna have to go pick up the kids. Yeah, that may be all the progress I can make today, but it feels good just to get a little more done. All right, well, I was right in the middle of that project, but I ran out of wire. Using these small spools of wire really stinks. I've got to get some more gas. I'm out of oxygen anyway, so maybe that'll be a trip for tomorrow to go to the gas shop and get welding gas and oxygen. I'm assuming we'll be open New Year's Eve. So try to do that and finish up. I'm not buying any more of these little spools. It's just not worth it. Just go right through them. And they're only like half the price of a big spool. And they probably last about a tenth as long. It's not worth it. But we'll do that and we'll get back to work.